Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the Psukim of Bitachon. Today's verse is a continuation of what we spoke about yesterday. Today is Tehillim 78, verse 22. And the reason that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gets angered and outraged and upset with Klal Yisrael is Ki lo ha'aminu be'Elokim, they don't have faith in Elohim, in God. And they do not trust in his salvation. When HaKadosh Baruch Hu looks down on a person in this world, and he sees that a person was given the insight and the wherewithal with the intellectual capacities and the spiritual being that Hashem imbued them with, they have the abilities within their grasp and in their hands to be able to recognize that everything that is going on in the world is always coming from the Ribbono Shel Olam. They have enough knowledge with the Torah that is accessible to them to learn about HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to study Hashem and His ways, to come in contact with the divine wisdom and understand what HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants from them. They're able to recognize that there's something called Hashgacha Pratis, the divine intervention, where Hashem literally is the one that is guiding every little single detail in one's life all of the time. A person was made to believe in Hashem. It's natural. Amunah, belief in HaKadosh Baruch, is something that is natural, just like it is natural that a bird will fly, and it is natural that fish will swim in the sea with their gills to allow them to breathe. And it is natural that the clouds will get filled with water and the rain will pour down. And it's natural that the sun will rise every single day to shed its light upon the world. So too, it is the nature of a human being to be a maimin, to believe in the Ribbono Shel Olam. From the youngest moments of a person's life, you can ask a child if they believe in God, and they will tell you the answer is yes, because it's so much a part of who they are. We are what's called Selem Elohim. We are created in the divine image, and that means that HaKadosh Baruch Hu blew a piece of himself inside each and every one of us. That means that there is a Chelek Eloka Mimal, there is a piece of Hashem inside of you, and since that's the essence of who you are, there is a natural belief, a natural connection that we have with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, because a piece of Him is inside of us. That being the case, it is only natural that we should believe in Hashem and that we should trust in Hashem and that we should follow HaKadosh Baruch Hu and we should do His bidding and His will. And when Hashem looks down on the world and He sees that we do not have faith, Ki lo ha'aminu be'Elokim, we don't trust in Elohim, and we don't b'adchu b'Yeshua, so we don't trust in His salvation, HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, the very nature of who you are, the very essence of that, what it means to be a human being, to be a Jew, you are missing that, you are going away from that, you are not following through with the divine mission that HaKadosh Baruch Hu has given you. That itself is enraging to Hashem. It's like a parent who watches one of their children misusing their abilities and their talents and their skills, not capitalizing on all of the great potential that they have been blessed with from birth. When a parent sees a child wasting away, not doing what they could be doing, not becoming the person they could become, not serving HaKadosh Baruch Hu the way that they could, not utilizing the brains that Hashem has given them for good things, but rather wasting it away on negativity and foolishness. There's a tsar, there's an anguish to the parent, there is a frustration that the parent will have when they look and they watch their child going in a negative direction from the great strides that they could be taking in life. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the Ava Rachamon. He is the Father in heaven. He's our Father of mercy. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu feels the loss of a Jew who does not live a life of Amun and Bitachon. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is frustrated when he sees a Jew that is living in a way that is so antithetical to the life of Amun and Bitachon. And therefore, says Dovid HaMelech in Tehillim, Ki lo ha'aminu be'Elokim, because they did not have faith in Hashem, in God, And they didn't trust that his salvation is coming. It's around the corner. HaKadosh Baruch is ready to save a person from whatever situation they're in life. But a person doesn't live with that emunah and that bitachon. So then the fires of rage and wrath come down upon that person, upon the world, because Hashem knows that we could do better. And we're not making the efforts that are necessary to live naturally with emunah and bitachon. Have a wonderful day.